Thanks. The Secretary of State in this state is grilled by lawmakers today over a flawed list of tens of thousands of potential non-citizens who voted. But David Whitley defended his office amid a pretty big controversy. Political reporter Jack Fink live over at the CBS Tower in Dallas with what unfolded today. Jack?
Well, Doug, elections experts say normally voter registration lists are reviewed quietly and behind the scenes, but this year that review became very political after the Texas Secretary of State, the Texas Attorney General's office, and the Texas GOP all issued news releases about the potential voter fraud.
I've learned a lot over the last 2 weeks.
Texas Secretary of State David Whitley on the political hot seat at his confirmation hearing today after his office publicly questioned whether 95,000 people identified by TPS as non-citizens were registered to vote and about 58,000 of them who actually voted.
I felt frustrated, outraged, and in shock.
Julieta Garibay's name was on the list even though she became a citizen last year and eligible to vote. The political uproar began when the Secretary of State sent the list of names to the Texas Attorney General's office for criminal prosecution, while at the same time telling county elections officials that the list may contain names that shouldn't be on there and that they need to verify them.
This is nothing but voter intimidation of to people of color and people who are naturalized citizens.
A parade of citizens testified against Whitley's confirmation, outnumbering those who supported him.
Own up and say, you know what, we made a mistake. We're going to withdraw that order.
Whitley said his office was following federal and state law, but that he realized a news release his office sent may have sparked the controversy.
I think a lot of misconceptions could have been cleared up on the front end if they were in the actual press release and not simply the advisory.
Governor Greg Abbott has defended the Secretary of State, calling this a work in progress, but he acknowledged the vocal complaints.
Maybe we need to find better, smoother ways of effectuating it so that it doesn't cause such a commotion.
And Governor Abbott says those ineligible to vote should not, and those who are should not be denied their right. Three lawsuits have now been filed against the state. The Senate Nominations Committee will vote on Whitley's confirmation next week. Live in Dallas, Jack Fink, CBS 11 News.
Jack, thank you.